second demonstration, we'll go over draft note disclosure. You know, imagine you had to create a first draft of a new note disclosure for your financial statements. And this is a common one in the public sector. So I figured we'd talk about asset retirement obligations that's coming to effect. Some of you have already done it or you've been thinking about it. So it's relevant. So what I've prompted the AI is, can you draft me a financial statement note disclosure for asset retirement obligations in accordance with public sector accounting standard PS 3280? So I've made a specific references. And it, you know, first it kind of prefaces, hey, this is just an example, you're gonna have to tailor it, we know that. And then it gives you what I would say is standard templated wording. Depending on the size of your organization, you're gonna have to fit this. It's giving, but the reality is, again, it's you know, as accountants, we do boring types of communication. They're very standardized. And this just took a split second for it to draft, and I have a starting point, and then now I can begin to tailor it to my organization. This is great. The next question I asked it is, okay, perhaps it's, this is going to happen a lot in the public sector is, can you draft me a financial statement, no disclosure for the impairment of non-financial assets in accordance with international public sector accounting standards? So as the PSAB has moved towards international standards, stakeholders aren't necessarily going to be familiar with that handbook. They're not going to know what's in there. They may have heard something. It might be daunting to research. And then here you are where you may have to provide some note disclosure. So I haven't looked up anything. I've just sort of told it that there's a standard here and it's under something called IFSAS. And it can, just like before, reach out and just give me a standard note disclosure. So it saved me a lot of time there when I'm trying to prepare my financial statements under time constraints. Again, this is generic wording, but generic wording or templated wording is what we use for a financial statement. So that's not, you know, that's not something that should deter me from using this tool. In fact, that's very encouraging in terms of the use cases for this tool for what we do in the business world. And now I'll just highlight here, the organization has not recognized any impairment loss in the current period for non-financial assets. Now I can continue the conversation with the AI and say, you know, can you revise last disclosure for a situation where the organization has recognized an impairment loss in the year? So I don't have to settle for the first thing it spits out. I can get it to revise, and it sort of gives me some placeholders to put numbers in where I might want to do that. And so that's sort of another thing to remember with the tool, is you don't have to stop at the first draft. You can get it and you can actually continue revising it. So when you're generating the first draft, you should play with the prompts to see how much more detail you can provide it and how it responds to that, because it might give you something closer and closer to a finished product. And then the final example, again, we just ask it to reach into IFSAS, its IFSAS knowledge base, and, you know, give us an example of intangible assets, which is something that will be more prevalent, in the public sector. And in this case, it's, system transition, where we're trying to capitalize, you know, the costs of setting up the system. And again, it gives me, a generic wording. I can go ahead and refine it more, but it gives me a starting point in just a matter of seconds. So, okay, a great time saver.